I'll come to one of my last questions. This is when it comes to the curriculum of each, medical, nursing, as well as engineering. In all three, you are seeing huge transformation of technology. It's artificial intelligence, machine learning, robotic surgery. And you go to any hospital, you can see nursing talent that is not experienced or find it difficult even for the very preliminary procedures to be executed. How do you improve curricula and the quality of talent that comes out? Industry Academy partnership is one, but at the ground level, how do you improve it? Employability, how can you improve?
With regard to nursing, I think it is possible only when the students are given adequate clinical exposure. And I'm happy to say that all the hospitals, all the colleges that we have, around 32, all of them have their hospitals. They are associated, and for certain other specialty things, they will go to other hospital, that's all. So the students are not just theory oriented, they are given a practical thing. Actually, to motivate a nurse, that is very important. They should see the result of their activity. See, giving an injection or putting an IV cannula, they should see that they have done it beautifully, yes. Then they feel that satisfaction, and then they will be motivated because they can see that then and there. So that happens in our training. And if that happens, then when they come out, they will be good nurses, excellent nurses. And everywhere we have seen that, say BSc nursing, the 4-year program, they have very limited clinical exposure. Because see, even if 4 hours of exposure, at that specific time when they are available in the hospital, that may not be the right time for doing all these procedures. So we have a limitation. That is why, just like a medical student, they are given a 1-year training. Because take it medical or nursing, they need to be fully into the system of total care. So that care aspect should come. When it is the academic part is there, they are preoccupied with their assignments, their projects and things like that. But once that is over, they have the theory background. With that background, they practice what they have learned. And that gives them confidence. So I can say that any nurse, those who have completed their 4-year BSc and have done that 1-year training in any of our institutions, you can give them confidently any job. They will do that.
Let me add to what Father Shaiju mentioned. Nursing education all over the world is almost standardized. The education one receives here in India and US education, exposure to technology may be different. But do you need all nurses to be familiar with the robotic surgery training? No. Very few. They learn the basic skills of nursing in general and specialties. Then they are able to acquire, like an engineering student itself, in medical. You are the first level, that is a MBBS. Then depending upon your aptitude, you specialize in something.
No, I was referring to how curricula is getting updated based on technology transformation. Or so, how outdated is the curricula?
See, if you are a deemed university or your own institute, you can have your own curriculum. Mm-hmm. But here, the curriculum is decided by the All India bodies like the Indian Nursing Council. Of course, vetted by the concerned university. And we, the institutions, have no choice in deciding the curriculum.
Same for medical as well?
Very good. What you add is you add some value by giving some extra training, extra exposure.
That how do you think about engineering? In engineering education.
3D design thinking. Okay.
Yeah.
Engineering actually, we are updating our syllabus and curriculum. You can see the technology is fast growing. It is not difficult. It is very difficult to bring all this technology in our curriculum. That is all. But the basic things we have to include. We already included in our engineering education. B.Tech level is actually we are giving focus on fundamentals of engineering. When you go for specialization, okay, we can go for all, we can go for each and every topic like that. But for engineering curriculum, when you frame a curriculum like that, it should be focused on the basis of engineering. That we have already included. At the same time, the life cycle of this technology is also very, very less when you are comparing with the software like that. Very less. So when you are going to incorporate all this one, people will focus on that only. They don't have any fundamentals. So that is one thing. But the applicability side, when we are going to apply this one, robotics, a new thing, they already included in our syllabus. There is no problem. Such things we are already incorporating in time, there is no doubt. But when we are going for, when we, the faculty is getting more freedom, in our university system, that freedom is not there.
IIT system.
In IIT, that freedom is there, the faculty can decide his syllabus. So that, and also IIT system, the faculty is, whatever he is teaching in the classroom, he will prepare the question paper, and he will answer, he will evaluate, and he will evaluate. Whereas in university system, it is not possible. That's it.
But a lot of innovation is taking place in engineering education. As you mentioned, some of the colleges have 3D printing facility, 3D printing. And that is an innovation for the students. Students are able to make some prototypes and they get only industry interaction also. So for example, through a 3D printer, you need a special, a custom developed implant for your jaws, matching your exact shape. The student gets an opportunity to develop the prototype and give it to the fabricator.
True.
Most of the colleges are attached to innovation center.
Yes.
That is there then in college. Because students, they are having a lot of idea. They are trying to bring their idea into product. Practice is actually we have started in many of the colleges.
Very late now.
Very late, that's all.
See, last week, some of a batch of 4 students in our engineering college, they have made an electric car, which is being looked upon with importance by the industry. The Maruti people already came and see this, so they have seen this development.
Okay.
And they will take it further. More than the product they have developed, their ambition and horizon enlarges. They will reach better heights.
So, and all government engineering colleges, they have their own startups.
Startup.
We are also promoting students for starting the startup projects. That process is here, but we started only late. That's the thing.
Government, of course, have their own limitations.
Yeah.
It will improve in engineering, but whereas
medical
in nursing, it is not possible. It's always
either
the basic thing
yeah.
that we have
yeah.
to train them. Then, of course, it is, and it is always a continuous learning process in nursing or medical. So, on-the-job training is very, very important.
Sure.
So, the continuing nursing education and medical education, it's an ongoing process.
See, let us see, what is the development that has taken place in Kerala for the last 15 or 20 years. There has not been much. The best, highest development has taken in the education sector. What is the investment made by the self-financing education sector in Kerala? Runs into several thousand crores. And employment opportunity. They have generated several lakhs of, an engineering college on an average employs 200 plus employees. A medical college will need about 2,500 employees, 2,500 plus. So like that, if you calculate the total number of institutions, it is not, we have calculated, counted only nursing, medical, engineering.
Yeah.
The others also, paramedical, arts and science. It is huge development. Second, these students passing out, they are not meant for our market only. We are targeting the world market. Our best export is our manpower. So the best training we give to our manpower, the earnings will be more. The per capita income or the income of the state increases. 4 intermittent systems.